should we do with our money to keep it safe? Craig Bolanos, CEO of Wealth Management Group in Downers Grove and Inverness, joins me on the phone this morning to help make sense of this. Good morning to you. Thanks for being with us.
Now, Sally, great to be back. It has been tough out there for the American investor.
Oh, indeed. I mean, it's just agonizing to watch that stock market fall and fall some more. If you still have money in the stock market at this point, you're worried about your 401k, what do we do?
Well, the first thing is, let's be honest, it's okay to worry. The events we've seen are somewhat unprecedented, but then again, maybe they're not. It feels somewhat eerily to me, a little bit like post 9/11. It feels a little bit like the Great Recession. And all I have to do to reinstill faith and confidence in myself is take a look at a mountain chart. We came back from those events. You have to put on the table that recovery is an option here for America, and I think some people shouldn't panic, especially at this point.
But I have heard some people saying that this is maybe like 9/11 plus the 2008 drop combined. Do you think it is unprecedented what we're going to be experiencing here?
Well, I think there is going to be changes all across this country in terms of industry. There's going to be new social norms. There's going to be a lot of things ushered in, but we have to take a look, and there's different types of bear markets. And I just want you to know that 9/11 and 08-09 were structural bear markets. Those are the worst kind. Investors right now need to remember that America was on the upswing. The economy was good when this started, and I don't want to diminish the fact that the news is going to get worse from here, but the reality is event-driven bear markets, which this is, tend to last around 15 to 16 months. There's plenty of history to support that, and I think the American consumer has a short memory. Once we all get off of quarantine, there is going to be some resurging activity in the back half of the year.
So let's talk about what we do right now. You say don't panic. Do we leave our money in? Do we start buying? What do we do?
Well, what I want everyone to do is, we've been talking about this in the press now for some 3 weeks, so it seems old, but it's never too late. The first thing is, anybody who is already retired or on the cusp of retirement needs to have 2 to 3 years of safe money, either cash or high-quality bonds, just in case. If you're a young investor, do not give up. You need to continue to put money in your 401k, continue to put money in your IRA, so long as you already have an emergency fund established. I want to put that on the table first.
Well, let's be honest, though, right now, a lot of people are looking at job loss. Maybe they lost their jobs already, or they're wondering if they're going to. They're wondering how they're going to continue to pay bills. What are some things that we can do with worries like that?
Well, that's a good question. Now, that is a everyone question. If you are a part of the gig economy and you've already seen your job wiped away, if you are in a position where you know in the coming weeks or the coming months it might be inevitable, I want everybody this weekend not to be a victim. I want everyone to reassert control. And the way we're going to do that is, first, you got to say, do I have enough cash in the bank, yes or no? Second, if you don't have enough cash in the bank, then maybe you do need to temporarily suspend making extra payments on your mortgage. Maybe you need to pull back a little from some of your kids' college savings that you're doing on a monthly basis. And now is a great time to go through all of your expenses and do what businesses do, cut out the fat, because there's got to be some services and subscriptions that aren't really that useful to you. Let's build up our cash in our bank just in case.
All right. For more on Craig's company, head to WMG.com. Craig Bolanos, thanks for taking the time to talk to us. I also know that some landlords and banks are willing to work with people to maybe push some of those payments you've got to, push them a little bit down the line. We appreciate your help this morning, Craig. It is now 8:36 on your Saturday morning. We know